Wait, hold on. Hold on. Wrong holiday? Too soon? What do you think? Too soon? Wrong video? This isn't the Make-A-Wish Foundation to save some kids in South Africa. This is Bang Rang, banging them out, nighttime edition. All right, so I'm gonna let you slide this time. No vice is necessary for this video since it's a night video. We're gonna go ahead and say no. We don't need to go ahead and say Malibu's finest. You know, all of a sudden I'm just a white gangsta in the house. None of that. Just a little video of the new. Little motivation goes a long way. So let's just do a little tour of what's going on over here. The camera missed it. Huh? there it is, right? In the house. Into fresh. Fozzie's baby. Uh-huh. So we're at the interlude contest. Uh-huh.
You should get your freaking, I'm gonna jack your freaking car, man, boy. We're at a Hollywood West,
the Maserati?
Man.
Where are we? I think we're in the beautiful streets
one.
Of
I don't forget about this one.
Oh, that's that's fresh.
Yeah, yeah.
That's clean. That's colorful.
It's from a munchkin.
Let's take a look inside this beautiful establishment. We're gonna take a look inside. Check, make sure we're looking good. So the cool thing is right here in front, you know, I'm tempted to almost like angle it. Maybe like that. What do you think? So that kind of just pops, kind of has like a nice look when you come in. Instead of facing inside, it's like you have to walk in. You get to admire the candy machine along with the Christmas machine, right? I think this is it. I think this is the money move right here. Yeah. What do you think? Yeah, that's the money move right there. So you walk in. And it's like, oh, this place has a candy machine. Super cool, right? So right now, this machine, this morning, I had to like gut out because, you know, it's this type of machine. And, the peanut M&Ms weren't cooperating. I'm trying to reduce the amount that I was giving out, but it was literally like giving out like 0, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and I was just like, dude, I can't have that. That's super annoying. I'm already worried that like places aren't gonna be happy if I'm giving out like 3 or 4 peanut M&Ms, although I feel like peanut M&Ms are much more popular than regular M&Ms. Oh, speaking of which, this needs to get changed. This is so misleading because people are gonna be like, oh, peanut M&Ms, and then they're gonna be all disappointed when they get traditional M&Ms. But the nice thing about this is you're gonna get like around 10 M&Ms, which still like isn't that much. I technically could be more generous, but to make the numbers work favorably and not have it be like an issue, I feel like 10's a money number. 10 to 12 on the Skittles, and then you're gonna get about 2 or 3 Starburst.
On a lucky day. Hey, you're doing one thing. Yeah.
On your best days. Those.
Hey, you
let's hope they don't give out one.
You fiddle faddle. Your fantasy enterprising on this whole fucking situation is one of those things. One of a kind.
There it goes. Those things aren't gonna last long.
You gotta twist this thing. You gotta put some money in this shit.
You gotta put some money in that.
Put the money in that shit.
Really nice bar. Look at that. That's cool.
Hey,
electronic
line,
darts?
I'm moving down the line.
Huh?
Hey, you got Count Dracula over here?
Yeah.
You got Paul over here? Good, straight up. Oh, dude, good. Huh? He's talking shit on me. Yo, look. Hey, look.
Oh, nice. Got a little auto tune. Huh? And we got some pool tables right here in the back. Really nice place. Huh?
Hey, come here.
Westside.
Westside.
Cool. See you later. So, you know, it's a different animal, the bar scene. Every place is different, and God, you know, who knows? But it doesn't look that busy. It is a Tuesday night early. It might pick up. Hopefully this place is open late. If it's open till 2, which I think it might be. You know, and if they're open all day, that's another key thing, right? We don't want a place that just opens like momentary, right? We want it to be like morning to close. But yeah, so the funny thing was, I'm calling all these places on the phone, and I started laughing, like actually like on a pitch to this like lady who picked up the phone, and I couldn't control my laugh. I just started laughing, and I think she started laughing. And then I tried to continue the pitch, and then I just kept laughing. And the reason was because it was like such a place that like wouldn't be a good fit for the candy machine. I think it was like her response of like, candy machine? Like inside or like outside or like here? I don't know if that was the right one, but just her response, or maybe just knowing the type of places that I was calling. Like, I make this list, and I don't even, like, I don't want to say I don't care, but I'm just kind of, like, I'm just grabbing all these bars, all these restaurants, you know? So, some of the times, I'm calling these places, I don't really know what they look like. I'm not taking the time to really, like, divulge into it too much, you know? I'm just kind of, like, just riffing it. And then all of a sudden, if I do look into it, I'm thinking, oh my God, this is like a nice restaurant that wouldn't want to even have anything to do with this, you know? And here I am, I'm like seriously pitching them. The funny thing is they're all employees, right? So it's like most of the time they have to give me like a real response because they're working, they're on the clock. They have to keep it professional. So as much as they want to tell me to like kick rocks, only like the owner can do that. I mean, don't get me wrong, you come across gatekeepers, you know, all the time that just want to like give you fat lip, but it's all good. Anyways, so I'm calling down the list. I made this list. Check this out. Okay, so packed up a couple candy machines this morning, went to go tinker on some machines, do some picking up of the money. As much as I want to do a collection video, collection was pretty sad today. Okay, the first place the guy was leaving, which meant his shop was shutting down here in Long Beach, the barber shop. And I'm thinking, oh shit, this guy's leaving, so the shop's closing. That's not a good sign. That means there's not other employees there, right? It's just him. And if he leaves, the place closes. He told me everything's good, people like it, it's not getting that much action. Just hearing that, you know, okay, it's probably been a couple months and there's probably like $20 in there. Not the numbers we're looking for. Then, so I didn't even get to go inside, or I was like, everything's working, no complaints. Yeah, okay, cool. Stocked up, move on to the next. I didn't get to collect. He was leaving. So a shop was shutting down. And then I just, before I left, here's the key, was I started typing in key phrases into Google Maps. Bars, food places, pizza, barber, safe, 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 safe. Because I'm not going to make any phone calls right now, but I could do it later, right? And then I went ahead, went to my other locations I haven't been to in a while. The next place, you know, a couple months, it had maybe $25 in it, and that guy wanted 30%, so I got to give him like $7.25, which leaves me $16, you know what I mean? Everything looked like fresh in the machine. There was some sun damage like hitting the machine, so the back of the M&Ms were getting a little crackle. But outside of that, it was good, so I could like leave it untouched, which is nice. That's why I like using those better quality machines. I can just go in, either fill them up or just wipe them down, move on to the next, right? Collect the money. Moving forward, stop by the new nail salon place. Well, guess what? It's only been like 6 weeks. That double gumball single candy machine, I put in Starburst in replacement so that I wouldn't be double gumball, and guess what? No Starbursts were coming out. I tried to fix it, still couldn't get Starbursts to come out properly. And I had two machines on me, so I was like, okay, do I switch it for another machine? or do I just give them gumballs? They do have a variety triple M&M slot, three M&Ms in one slot. So that's essentially three candies right there. And then one specialty gumball. I decided to just put a second specialty gumball because I was running out of time before traffic caved in. And so that only had about 10 bucks in it, like 9 bucks. I gave $2 away, a little bit more, like 250, because I felt bad that they were losing their money on the Starburst. No one said anything, but one of the girls came out and said, "Hey, are you leaving? Do you have more of those cups?" And I was like, "Oh, I don't, because I'm not prepared all the way." But I did like that she wanted cups, right? So there's a demand for the cups, because she probably pours that candy in, sits back in her comfy seat, snacks away, right? Unfortunately, I don't think I'm making much money off the M&Ms, but if that keeps them happy, and then people buy the gumballs, then we're good, right? Averages out. It's hard to be generous with those M&Ms, dude. It's tough, right? Because they're so expensive. Then I moved on to one more location, and it's been a couple months, and that place had about 30. I gave him $4.50, so it must have had 20 something, probably 20 bucks ish. So not the best numbers, because after that I'm left with 16. So what did I really make? First run, zero. Then I made like 16. Then I made like 8, 7. And then I made 16. So essentially, I collected 40 bucks. One place was untouched. Probably another 15, 20. But I collected maybe 40 bucks. And yeah. So anyways, go back to my house before I beat the traffic. I decided to pig out and then make some phone calls as I'm doing it. And guess what? Well, proof is in the pudding. And guess what? All those places that I save earlier here in Long Beach, I didn't have time. I hate to use that phrase, but I really didn't, because I was like on a race because I can't stand traffic. At each of the locations I went to, I wanted to collect leads, right? Because new ones pop up when I'm in that area than I can find for my house. That's just how it works. But I did it here in LBC. So when I'm home, I'm calling down the list. I'm laughing to myself because I'm calling all these places and I sound like a crazy person, because it's like, who wants a candy machine, right? It's so ridiculous, you know? And all of a sudden, I'm calling the bar. I'm calling just random, you know, whatever place. And, oh, yeah, like the candy machines. And I just give the pitch. Oh, yeah, you know, I set them up, maintain them, restock them. They're space efficient, no electricity. 20% of the total sales goes to the house, which is about half the profit. There's no contract. You can opt out anytime. And there's zero liability, you know. For some, anything happens to the machine, it's on me. You know, if you want to come, and I leave my number, I leave my information on the machine. So if you need maintenance, restock, or if you just want me to come pick it up, I won't even try to resell you on it. I'll just pick it up, say thank you. It's part of my pitch right there, right? And she was like, "Oh yeah, we used to have one of those. That'd be great. Yeah, well, yeah, we want one. My name's Lisa. When I called." I gave the quick pitch, which is, "Oh, hey, who could I talk to about setting up a complimentary quarter candy machine in your waiting area?" And she's like, "Oh, that's me." And then I was like, "Oh, cool." And I was like, "Yeah, so, I set them up, maintain them, restock them, they're space efficient, no electricity, just jump right into it, right? No formalities. Don't waste anyone's time. I recommend that. So do the pros, right?" And when I mean pros, I mean like rich people. And then she's like, "Oh, yeah, we used to have one. I think they're great. Yeah, we want one. My name is Lisa. I'll be here tonight and tomorrow and the next day." And I was like, "Awesome. I'll be right over." And she's like, "Okay, great." And I was like, "Perfect." So sure enough, I did my work earlier when I first woke up, which was gutting out that machine, tinkering it, which was getting really old and annoying and frustrating, because like I said, I couldn't get the M&Ms right, The measurements amounts were just not proper, and so I had to put in a lot of tinkering. I had to clean out because, you know, even the Skittles was like melting on the edges, so I had to like clean it out, gut it out. I had to set it to the right adjustments, and I got through the motions. And guess what? It pays off, because now when I'm making the phone calls and someone says, "Yeah, we want one," I can say confidently, "I'll be right over," knowing that the back work is done and this machine's ready to go. I have the key ready, I got the screws, I have the candy already in. Speaking of the stickers, it does have a peanut sticker. I don't know if I have a M&M sticker on here. I'm gonna have to look. But anyways, so just letting you know, that's what it takes to get a location. You gotta gather up the leads, you gotta call up the leads, and you gotta get past the, you know, feeling uncomfortable calling all the wrong places, because look how quick it changes from a whole bunch of no's to a quick yes, okay? And a whole bunch of no's, I wasn't calling for that long, right? I would say modestly an hour or two. An hour or two, I was making phone calls and I got a location, right? Which is honestly huge if you're looking to get like 100 locations. I called for an hour or two, I got a location. We'll do the math on that. So if you times an hour or two by 100, you're telling me I'd have all my locations? That's pretty sweet. Keep in mind, and also getting to 100 is a lot different than getting to 100 right locations. Okay, because I lost a couple locations this week. I went into Circle City Barbers in Orange, which I thought was going to be one of the best places of my whole roster. And as soon as I walk in, they're like, "Hey, you need to take the machine." And I'm like, "All right, sweet." You know, it's no emotion. It's no try to resell them on it. It's no, "Oh, gee whiz, why, guys, hold on. What's going on? Why do you want to get rid of it?" No, I'm just like, yeah, totally. You know? And I look in the machine, there's hardly anything in there. They're like, "Yeah, no one's using it." And I wasn't doing a good job keeping up on keeping the candy clean either. I think it was getting a lot of sun damage and it was like expiring a lot. So I was having issues with that. But nonetheless, I took the machine out, cleaned it up, and look at this. I found a new home for it here. Hopefully it'll be much better. The nice thing is the temperature is nice and it's dark. The candy will stay a lot fresher. But why would I fret about having that location that's not doing well? That machine was not selling any candy, so I literally am missing out on making money with a candy machine that's just sitting there, being unproductive. What's the point? To buy a nice machine with a silver chrome trim to sit it in a place that makes no money. You're helping me out by saying, "Hey, you need to take the machine." Because sometimes it's almost like I'm like, "Oh, I'll come back and get around to it, and I'll find it at home, and then I'll come pick it up. And I have so many more at my house that I need to get through. I'll just leave it here because I have nowhere to put it." Sometimes you just need that kick in the ass that's like, "Hey, take the machine, get it the fuck out of here, and find it a new home." And then you got to be like, "Okay, I got to take it. I got to find a new place." And then guess what? You do, and it feels good, because I guarantee it's going to do a lot better here than it will at another at that location. I lost another location recently. I lost that pizza place in HB. I think we already talked about Ria Pizza. I was pissed off because the guy had the machine facing inside, hidden away from the windows as well. Literally just killing any sort of... He's like, "Yeah, I did well at the beginning." And I'm thinking, "Yeah, I did well at the beginning because you had it facing the outside where everyone could see it just walking by, you putz. You know, what are you doing?" But anyways, I lost something more recent as well. I went to Costino's Pizza in Mission Viejo. It's been a couple months. I went to get my haircut. I went and checked on my bar location. That one, guess what? Two coins were stuck in two of the mechs in this shitty-ass red used machine. The whole thing was pretty much empty. That means the whole thing sold out, and now two of the things aren't even working. And I'm thinking, dude, how long has it been like this? So ridiculous. Why are you sucking? You know? And so I had to, I don't like to pull the machine before I replace it, right? So I just said, you know, I'll be back. I had like $50 in the back, right? Fucking A. So then I went to Costino's Pizza in Mission Viejo after I got my haircut. And then I look this way. My machine's not there. And I see the owner. And he plays like he doesn't recognize me. And then I look back at where the machine is. And I think he realized at this point the jig was up. And so he was like, oh, I'm the owner, blah, blah, blah. I'm like thinking, yeah, dude, I met you. Where's my machine? And he's like, oh, it's in the back because, you know, one thing wasn't coming out and the other ones was sounding expired, right? And I'm thinking, oh, shit, you know. But then he was like, you know what, this place is dead anyways. It wasn't getting much action. I don't have that much people coming in here. Usually it's just parents picking up their food for their families and coming back home, you know, that aren't going to use it anyways. And then he just kind of dug into me and was like, oh, I got two great locations in San Clemente that would just kill. You know, pizza and ice cream parlor right on the beach. But my neighbor, he won't allow it because, you know, he'll get pissed off because he has his own vending. And I'm thinking, he's like, but it would do so great. It would do so great. I'm thinking, awesome. Just tease me, asshole. Just let me get my machine and bounce. And, but, you know, I mean, he's cool. Everyone's got their own personality, right? But those locations, he's right, those locations would kill. So I pulled the machine. And it's not an awesome, because I don't like that specific machine. It's one of my better ones. It's a new green Rhino Pro. So it's a good machine, you know. It'd be my later ones to sell. But I was like, oh my God, let me gut this puppy out, and then I'll go put it at the bar. Perfect. Because I was already down in that area. So I gutted it out, put some fresh candy in, boom, 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 set it up at the bar, pulled the red one. I'm going to just chuck the red one. When I mean chuck it, I mean I'm going to sell it. Because now I'm trying to upgrade all my machines, right? Just because you climb the wrong hill doesn't mean you should keep climbing it, right? Come back down, go to the right hill, climb it up. And what I mean by that is I want to replace all these machines with better quality machines because my candy won't expire and I won't have to do so much maintenance on them, right? This is supposed to be passive. It's not supposed to be a pain in the ass. But hey, he's doing me a favor by saying, yeah, take your machine. Thank God I would have kept it there. Guess what? He wanted me to open it right in front of him, give him half the money. I'll give you half the money. $9 in there, dude. And here's $4.50. You know, you're doing me a favor because here I have a nice machine that made $9 in a couple months. Whether I had like it stocked up properly with fresh candy, whether he kept it back there, probably wouldn't have had much more than that. And now here I put it in a great home, the bar, which will do much better. It'll be more efficient. Coins won't get stuck in this machine. So it's a win-win-win. And so, yeah, let me lose these locations, you know. I need to get to the point where I can have the balls to say, I need to pull this location. I need to pull this. You know, it's not doing good. I got a bunch of those locations. And the machines either need to get sold or they need to move on to new homes. So, anyways, just showing you, hey, look at the process. You went to go work on a machine. You did the right thing by collecting more leads, which is super key. You went back home, started making the phone calls, and bada bing, bada boom, you set one up just like that. All right. Peace out. Till next time.